Today on BRStv, we're going to let you know why magnesium is the magic that holds our reef tanks together. Hi, I'm Ryan, your host of BRStv, where each week we cover a new topic related to reefing. Over the last 2 weeks, we explored calcium and alkalinity. This week, we're going to cover magnesium, which is the element which basically makes reefing possible. In this episode, we'll cover why magnesium is important and how to use magnesium chloride and sulfate to raise and maintain your levels. First component is, like calcium and alkalinity, magnesium is used by corals for metabolic function to stay healthy and grow. However, most tanks, corals don't consume large amounts of magnesium. Magnesium is typically abundant, consumption is slow, and it's fairly easy to keep up with magnesium demands with infrequent additions of a supplement like magnesium chloride, or sometimes even just water changes. The more important role of magnesium is related to overall tank chemistry. To fully understand the importance of magnesium, we need to spend 20 seconds reviewing the importance of calcium and alkalinity. If you watched our calcium and alkalinity videos, you probably have a pretty good idea that corals maintain growth and health by building a skeletal structure made from calcium carbonate. Right now, your tank is filled with tiny little calcium and carbonate or bicarbonate ions, which are the primary components of your tank's calcium and alkalinity. Corals are more or less collecting these ions from the surrounding water within their soft tissue and precipitating them out as calcium carbonate onto their skeletal structure for growth. The part that's somewhat tricky is, not only can the corals use these ions to build their skeletal structures, but the calcium and carbonate ions have a natural affinity for each other in the water as well, so they can find each other in the tank and form calcium carbonate basically anywhere in the tank. The most common place you'd see this is the white calcium carbonate crust on elements like heaters and pumps, but this is also happening as little tiny particles that eventually settle out in the sand. This is where magnesium comes in, by preventing the calcium and carbonate from finding each other. While calcium is typically around 420 parts per million, magnesium is more than triple that at around 1350 parts per million. In basic terms, magnesium prevents calcium carbonate crystals from growing by incorporating itself into the growing calcium carbonate crystal and making it unattractive to additional calcium and carbonate ions. In short, it's the magnesium which allows us to maintain appropriate levels of calcium and alkalinity. If your magnesium is low, you'll likely have problems maintaining proper calcium and alkalinity levels, and you might be seeing a lot of white crust building on all of your equipment. Now that we understand magnesium's role in both metabolic function and general water chemistry, how do we raise and maintain it? The most common additive is magnesium chloride, and to a lesser degree, magnesium sulfate. Most reefers select magnesium chloride because chloride is the most abundant ion in seawater, so additions have a very small impact on overall water chemistry. Like calcium and alkalinity, we start by testing our parameters. The two most common test kits are the Salifert and Red Sea. The Salifert is the lowest cost of the two and widely trusted by reefers all over. The Red Sea kit costs more initially, but comes with high quality components and has some inexpensive refill kits available, which makes it the lowest cost option over the long haul. Next, we're going to go to the reef calculator on our site, enter the total system water volume, which is your tank plus sump minus rock and sand. So a 100-gallon tank might really only have 80 gallons of water once you take the rock and sand out. A 20-gallon sump might have around 10 gallons of actual water, so we could enter a total of 90 gallons. Don't get hung up on getting this perfect. A good guess is likely to get you within 10%, which is likely below what a test kit is even capable of registering anyways. Let's say our current magnesium level is 1200 and we want it to be 1350. We'll enter that in the desired magnesium level and current magnesium level fields. Now select what you're going to use to raise your levels. By far the most common options are the magnesium chloride crystals, which is a dry crystal which need to be dissolved in water prior to use. The other popular option is a BRS magnesium mix solution, which is just a jug of purified water and magnesium which has already been dissolved. In my opinion, it's just easier to have a jug pre-mixed and ready for use. The ideal mix for this is 7 1/4 cup magnesium chloride and 3/4 cup magnesium sulfate, with enough purified water to make a gallon of solution. The mix of magnesium chloride and magnesium sulfate most closely matches the natural ratio of chloride to sulfate in natural seawater, and why we call it the ideal solution. If you don't have any magnesium sulfate on hand, most reefers find it acceptable to skip the sulfate and just use 8 cups of magnesium chloride and enough purified water to make a gallon of solution. Personally, I try and make the ideal mix whenever possible, but I wouldn't hesitate to use the magnesium chloride only option if I didn't have any magnesium sulfate on hand. There's also a special magnesium mix if you're dosing 2-part on a daily basis. For information related to that, I would check out one of our 2-part videos. I normally dose a pre-mixed solution, so I'm going to select the BRS Magnesium Mixed Solution and hit Calculate. It tells me to dose 1,088 milliliters with some general notes on how to do it. More or less pour it into a high flow area of the tank and avoid blasting corals. Notice it says not to raise the levels more than 100 parts per million per day, so I'll probably split the dose up over 2 days. Once the full dose has been added, wait a few minutes for the solution to dissipate in the tank, test your levels, and it should be exactly where you wanted them to be. Couple notes on mixing, you should do it with purified water like distilled or RODI. There's a lot of salt being dissolved here, so it'll take some shaking. It's not uncommon to see some salt crystals at the bottom of the jug. You can let the jug rest overnight or float in a sink of hot water, which will help dissolve the salt fully. We use pharmaceutical grade magnesium chloride and sulfate to produce our magnesium additives, so as long as you use purified water like RODI, it should result in a crystal clear solution. One last note, it's super common for salt mixes to be low in magnesium, presumably because it's one of the more expensive components. So if you're using a salt mix with low magnesium to begin with, most reefers will give it a boost directly in the salt mixing container before doing a water change, so the water change isn't effectively lowering the magnesium levels in the tank. We'll see you next Friday with another episode of BRStv, so subscribe if you haven't already. But if you can't wait, check out this video on do-it-yourself two-part containers, a test we did on chloramines in our water here at BRS, or how to build your own rail kit for radions. See you next week with another episode of BRStv.